you know, this is war. This isn't a game of football or a game of cricket. So we need to be all in and give them all they need to succeed. They've shown they've got the talent. They've fought like nothing that we can imagine. It's their national survival. They're our allies. We should back them to the hilt.
Well, yes. I mean, the war is definitely hotting up in terms of in the last month, 6 weeks, we've seen the Ukrainian offensive into Western Russia. We've seen Russia responding quite forcefully with its own air bombardments onto Ukrainian civilians. I mean, across the country, they've been trying to hit various Ukrainian targets. We've seen fierce fighting in the Donbass region. And now we're seeing Ukraine extending the war as far as it can go, using its sort of drone attacks into Moscow to try and disrupt ordinary life in the Russian capital. I think it is a strong move by Ukraine to take the fight to Moscow. It's designed to bring the war again to the attention of ordinary Russians, to say things are not going well for you. And Mr. Putin claimed this would be written a week. It's now 2.5 years and we're attacking your capital city. So what do you think about that? Do you not think there needs to be a change? Whether it'll achieve that change is another matter, but it is a statement of intent to say that Ukraine's going nowhere and will continue to cause Russia problems in this war of Putin's choosing. You know, your country's invaded in a major way for the first time since the Second World War. And again, it's only been invaded because you've attacked someone else. So it's not as if it was an unprovoked attack of aggression by the neighbor. It was, in fact, your aggression that sparked it. So things have gone badly wrong. And then your capital city being hit by significant numbers of drones. Again, it's a huge, huge embarrassment for Putin. And the more that happens, the more embarrassed he's going to be. And the more questions are going to start being raised about what the point of the war is and what the point of Putin himself is, given that he seems incapable of protecting Russia from its, you know, the consequences of its own aggression. What Ukraine has been very successful at doing the last 2 months is to remind the West that the war can be won. There was a feeling, I think, that there was stalemate developing. Nobody knew what was happening. It was sort of drifting off the news. And Ukraine needed to take a risk. It needed to do something quite dramatic to remind the West of the ability of its ally on the ground to actually win the conflict. All it needs is for the West to do its bit and supply it with the weapons, with the missiles, to actually do the job and finish Putin's regime off in that way. Now, that is obviously going to be taken, positively by the UK and US. I would be hopeful that there will be a decision made very soon on the long-range missiles issue, because it's clear that attacking Russia's drone and missile bases will help alleviate the pressure on not simply Ukraine civilians, which is important, but also on a number of the Ukrainian military installations that are being attacked as well from long distance. And these are fair targets in war. These are, sites that are being used for offensive purposes. And currently they're simply off limits because we're not allowing Ukraine to use the weapons it's got to attack them. That needs to change right now. The Ukrainians need every bit of help they can get to reflect their own bravery, to reflect the risks they've taken, to show that those aren't going to be punished, but instead they're going to be rewarded by the support needed to bring this war to a close on terms that will be fair to the Ukrainians, which is, of course, the only thing we should be interested in. Putin needs to, his forces need to withdraw from Russia in exchange, obviously, for a Ukrainian withdrawal from Russia. And there needs to be reparations paid as well for the crimes he's committed in Ukraine. Anything short of that is going to legitimize aggression. It's going to legitimize the use of force. And that is not a message that we can have being sent out, given the number of predators who are out there looking to see the outcome of this conflict before they launch their own potential attacks on their neighbors.